Good morning, children. We are studying chapter 6, Changes Around Us. In that chapter, we discussed many examples for reversible and irreversible changes, and we completed activity up to 6. Now let's discuss activity 7. Take a small candle and measure its length with the scale. Now fix it at a suitable place and light it. Let it burn for some time. Now blow the candle and measure the length of the candle again. I have a candle here. It measures about 5.5 centimeter in length. Okay. Now let's see after burning for some time what will be its length. See children, I have lighted the candle. Okay. Let's burn for some time. Let it burn for some time. Okay. Afterwards, we'll measure its length. Okay. You just observe the picture 6.9 in your textbook, page number 49. Here, heating of wax is given. If we take a wax in a pan and if we heat it, what happens? The wax will be melted and it remains in the pan itself. Okay. No height or no volume will be decreased. After the melted wax get condensed, the original wax can be got back. So we can say it as reversible change. Okay. Let me put off this candle and now measure the length of it. Okay. How much it measures? Let's see. Now this candle measures the length of 5 cm. Before lighting the candle, it was 5.5 cm. Now 0.5 cm has been melted. So this change cannot be reversed. So it is an example of irreversible change. Let's see some more example for irreversible changes. Okay. In the same way, if we burn the incense sticks, okay, agarbatti, okay, if we burn it, what happened? It produced some new material. These are ash and some gases. We can't see this gas, but we can sense them due to their pleasant smell. Can this change be reversed? No, not at all. And what about the change which occurred in the matchstick we used for lighting the candle or incense stick? The same change only, that is irreversible change. By the action of friction, when we strike the matchstick along the sides of the matchbox, it gets fired, is it? But we can't get the matchstick again. So it is irreversible change. So far we discussed the changes occurring in a given object or its material. What about the changes that occur when two substances are mixed together? Okay. So far we have seen changes in one substance. Okay. One substance or a material. Now we are going to discuss about when two substances or two things are mixed together, what changes will be brought. Okay. In chapter 4, we dissolved salt in water. Do you think a change occurred in salt or in water? Here, two things undergoes for a change, salt and water. Okay. It mixes together and forms a aqueous solution of salt water. Okay. Here, which thing we can say has undergone change? We can't say. Is it? Is it possible to reverse this change? Yes. In chapter 5, we learnt how to separate salt from its solution in water by the method of evaporation. I hope you would have remembered. So, we can say that the change due to dissolving salt in water be reversed. Yes, it can be reversed, but we have to apply some energy. By applying heat energy, the water will get evaporated and we will get the salt back. Pahali asked if you have ever seen curd being set. A small quantity of curd added to warm milk. The milk is stirred and is set aside for few hours at a warm place. In a few hours, the milk changed into curd. This change cannot be reversed. This is the change we can easily observe. We are practicing in our home every day. This change can be reversed? No, not at all. This is an irreversible change. So far from our discussions, we find that a few ways to bring a change in a substance could be heating it or by mixing it with some other substance. We also find that a change can be reversed while other changes cannot be reversed. There may be many other ways of changing it around us. It is possible that some of them can be reversed, some of them cannot be reversed. Okay, so they are grouped into two major groups: reversible changes and irreversible changes. Okay, as a conclusion, there are changes of two types. Generally, they are reversible and irreversible. In higher classes, you will learn about in detail. Okay, you will learn these changes in detail. Okay, how they are grouped further in a many ways. That's all about this chapter, children. We'll discuss the overview in our online class. Okay, thank you, children.